In this part, we'll talk about vegetative reproduction in diatoms. Now, when they reproduce vegetatively, that means in an asexual mode, the division is mitotic. So, the vegetative reproduction takes place by mitotic division or mitosis, and this takes place during night. So these are two important things which are there. Now, how exactly this reproduction takes place? To understand what happens, what we are going to do is we will use different colors for showing hypotheca and epitheca, and I'm going to draw the diatom like this. So say this is one half, that is the epitheca, and this is the hypotheca. So let us label this. This is hypotheca and the bigger one is epitheca. And purposefully we are showing it with different color. Now what happens is during vegetative reproduction, the protoplasmic mass, that is the protoplast, except the cell wall, swells. So here there is this protoplasmic part. This protoplasmic part, it swells. So when it swells, the two halves, they get separated. So this is the epitheca which has been pushed a little out, and this is the hypotheca which has been pushed a little out. Now the two halves, they separate. The division takes place here. There is one nucleus, the nucleus divides. So now there are two nuclei, and we find that the cytoplasmic content also divides into two parts. So there are now two halves, and the cytoplasm has also divided into two halves. Now what happens is there are two parts which we are going to draw. This is the epitheca, and we are maintaining the same size. And this one is the hypotheca. Hypotheca is smaller than the epitheca. The cytoplasmic content is also there. The cytoplasmic content with its nucleus, and with its nucleus here. Now, the two parts which are formed, division is mitotic. So both the nuclei are diploid nuclei. But each half is having only one half of the cell wall. This one is having only epitheca, and this one is getting only hypotheca. Now in both, here this part is going to act as epitheca, and it will secrete a new hypotheca. So epitheca is the old one. So this is old epitheca. And this is the new hypotheca which has been secreted. In this case, this is the original hypotheca which is going to act like epitheca, which acts like epitheca. So now, if this acts as epitheca, it is going to secrete the smaller half. That means this is going to be the hypotheca. Now if we compare these two cells or these two halves which are there, this one is pretty much of the same size as that of the parent cell. Reason, it is retaining the epitheca. So epitheca is the bigger half. Here also the same half is there, and it is going to secrete the hypotheca, which is going to be smaller. So size is going to remain as big as the epitheca. But in this case, hypotheca is behaving or acting like epitheca, and there is a new hypotheca which is secreted. That means here the size is going to get smaller. Now if this reproduction continues, then what is going to happen? This will again divide into two parts. We'll continue it here. So now, suppose we are talking with about this one. So what happens is, the epitheca, which is the bigger one, along with its cytoplasmic content, because mitosis will again take place, and this will be its hypotheca, which is smaller than this, with its cytoplasmic content. Now what will happen is, this will secrete its own hypotheca. So the size of this one and this one and the original cell, they are pretty much same because they are retaining the same original epitheca. But this hypotheca, which is now going to act as epitheca, and here a new hypotheca would be synthesized. So in this case, one cell will retain the normal size and one cell will be smaller. So if this continues, we will keep getting one cell normal size, one cell smaller. What will happen with this one? Suppose this now divides. So we will take this here. Now what has happened? The hypotheca and epitheca will separate. So this is the separated newly formed hypotheca, which is smaller, and this is the epitheca of this, which was original hypotheca of the parent cell. That means the sizes of hypotheca. So hypotheca is smaller, which is acting as epitheca, and when it secretes its new hypotheca, that is even smaller in size. So now they have their own protoplasmic material with the nucleus, because it is always followed by mitotic division. Every separated half is going to act as epitheca. So now there is a new hypotheca for this and new hypotheca for this. So in this case, what is going to happen is, one cell will be of this size, which is going to retain its epitheca, and the other cell is going to be smaller, which gets its hypotheca, because hypotheca is going to become like epitheca. So what is happening in this vegetative reproduction is that gradually the size of the cell is decreasing. So slowly and gradually at every step, the newer cells which are formed, they get smaller and smaller and smaller. Now there has to be some method of correction so that all the new cells, all the smaller cells, they actually become to, or they come to the normal cell size, because we know that the cell nucleus ratio has to be maintained and it is very essential for the normal functioning. So how is this size correction? Size correction takes place by sexual reproduction. So when these cells, right now they are dividing by asexual means, vegetative means. Division is mitosis. When they undergo sexual reproduction, the reproduction is called by oxospore formation. When that happens, at that time, the size correction will take place. That means sexual reproduction is going to play two important roles. One, mixing of genetic material, which is the most significant point of sexual reproduction, and size correction. So here, in this case, sexual reproduction plays two distinct roles apart from the main function, that is the genetic recombination. It will also bring all those smaller cells to the normal size. In the next part, we'll see how this sexual reproduction takes place. So asexual reproduction is simple. The two halves are going to separate. Only thing that we have to remember is, after separation, each half, whether it was original epitheca of the parent cell or hypotheca of the parent cell, is going to behave like epitheca, and they would secrete a new half, which is going to be smaller, and that new half will always act as hypotheca. So next part, we'll take up this sexual reproduction.